Hello students, welcome to the English class. Today let's discuss the short story titled A Wrong Man in Worker's Paradise, written by Rabindranath Tagore. This short story is part of the English textbook named English in Use, prescribed by the Osmania University for its second year undergraduate students. This lesson comes in the third semester and it is part of unit 1. Okay, so let's go to the first slide. Yeah, this is about the author. The writer is Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore was born on 7th May in 1861 in Kolkata. His parents were Debendranath and Sharada Devi. Tagore was very interested in writing poems even from his early age. When he was just 14 years old, he began writing poems. He was not educated in school. He was educated at home in his early childhood. At the age of 17, he was sent to England for formal schooling. But however, he returned without completing the studies. He was sent there to study law, but he didn't like that. So he came back to India and he continued writing poetry. He participated in the Indian Nationalist Movement. He was given the Knight title by the British government in 1915. He resigned the honor as a protest against the Jallianwala Bagh in 1919. He was given the honorific title Gurudev by Mahatma Gandhi. He started Shanti Niketan, an experimental school, which was later known as Vishwabharati University. It was actually established by his father, and Tagore later expanded it. There he follows the Upanishad style of education, which means that the student comes and sits near the teacher. It is like a one-on-one class and they talk about ideas. The teacher speaks depending upon the intellectual and emotional level of the student that he is speaking to. It is a one-on-one session, depending upon the caliber of the student, the teacher demonstrates the class. And another notable thing to mention about Rabindranath Tagore is he is the first Asian to receive Nobel Prize. That is, in 1913, he received a Nobel Prize for his seminal work, Gitanjali. Very famous work. He is a multifaceted artist. He is a poet, a novelist, playwright, painter, and even a music composer. You might have heard about Rabindra Sangeet in Bengali. He writes in Bengali and he self-translates them into English also. He is a self-translator. He is also a philosopher and a visionary educationist. We have already mentioned about Shanti Niketan, the present Vishwabharati University. His notable works are Gitanjali, Daggar and Gare Baire. Most of his works are in Bengali. Some of his works he has translated on his own and other works are translated by other writers. So here we are given a short story, A Wrong Man in Worker's Paradise. That is also a translation of his work from Bengali. It is originally written in Bengali and it is translated by Bhavani Bhattacharya. Let's go to the next slide. Now, this Wrong Man in Worker's Paradise illustrates the famous slogan, art for art's sake. So this is a kind of simple, funny kind of story, but thought-provoking, and it is based on the slogan, art for art's sake. Now, what is art for art's sake? It is actually coined by the French philosopher Victor Cousin in 19th century. This means that this slogan means that art needs no justification at all. Art need not be conveying any message. It should not be moralistic. It should not be didactic and all. Art can be just done for the pleasure of doing it. Art need not serve any political, didactic, moral or practical purpose. There need not be any practical purpose of it. You can just involve in art for the sheer pleasure of getting involved in it. Only objective of art is the pursuit of pure beauty. So here I have given a picture of Victor Cousin and his quotation where he talks about the principle art for art's sake. We need religion for religion's sake, morality for morality's sake, and art for art's sake. Art is only for the sake of art, and there is no hidden purpose behind the art. Behind art. Let's go to the short story, A Wrong Man in Worker's Paradise. This is a short story written by the great Rabindranath Tagore, and it first appeared on the Spectator in Bengali. It is translated from original Bengali text by Bhavani Bhattacharya. Now, who are the characters involved? Let us discuss who are the characters involved in this story. There is a person, an artist, who is called a wrong man in this story. And you have an aerial messenger in this who takes the people who are dead to heaven or hell according to the qualities they pursue. Then you have the silent girl of the torrent. You also have lot of workaholic men and women in the workers' paradise. You have a part of heaven established in the story. The environment is set in the workers' paradise. Now, what is the concept of the story? The story deals with an artist who was considered whimsical by majority. You have an artist who spends most of his time doing useless things. Other people consider his pastime as useless. There is no utility in whatever he is doing. So they consider him his life as useless. The young man was wrongly taken to workers' paradise by the aerial messenger, but he is very lucky. He is taken to the workers' paradise where gems are taken to in the heaven. So he is mistakenly taken to that place by the aerial messenger. He becomes a misfit in the world of hard workers, but he is not comfortable there at all. He finds only hardworking people over there and he is not even able to talk to them. Okay, a young girl gets attracted by the artwork of the wrong man, and the story continues making us feel that all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. So he tries to get acquainted with a young lady over there, and the story continues. So let's read the story. I have divided the story into different parts and have put the text as it is in the coming slides. So let us read the story and then let us discuss. Okay students, yeah, the story begins like this. The man never believed in utility. Having had no useful work to do, he indulged in mad whims. So this man is an artist, and he spent his whole life for art. He didn't do anything useful in life. His life was only for art, and that art is only for the sake of pleasure. That art did not have any message in it. That art did not portray anything related to life, but it was only done for his sheer pleasure. So other people considered it as useless. So he didn't have any useful work to do. He just indulged in his mad fantasies. He made little pieces of sculpture, men, women, castles. So whatever available, he made sculpture out of it. That too not very beautiful. People didn't find it beautiful at all. He painted Thus, he wasted his time on all that was useless and unnecessary. Majority of the people considered his artwork as useless and unnecessary waste of time. So what people did? People just laughed at him. What a creature. How is he wasting life? He is not at all useful to others, useful to himself and useful to others also. Sometimes he would vow to shake off his mad whims, but his mad whims would keep him clinging to his mind. Sometimes out of conscience and out of seeing the people's response, he tried to change, but then finally he will come back to the earlier form. He will just resort to his painting works and sculpture. Some boys never ply their books and yet pass their examination. I know there are people like this in your group also. There will be some lucky boys and girls who never read their books properly but pass their examination with flying colors. A similar thing happened to this man. So this man is also very lucky. When the aerial messenger came to pick up the gems from the earth, he noticed this man and mistakenly he took him to workers' paradise in heaven. He spent all his life in unnecessary work on the planet earth, yet after his death, the gates of heaven flung open for him. He didn't do any worthy thing in his life, but even then he is very lucky. He is taken to heaven, that too in the busiest place in the heaven, that is the workers' paradise. But the moving finger writes even in the heavens. So it came to pass that aerial messenger who took charge of the man made a mistake and found a place for him in workers' paradise. So his fate, his destiny is so beautiful. Even if he didn't do anything useful in life, he was taken to heaven, and that too the busiest place and the crowded place in heaven, that is the workers' paradise. In this paradise, you will find everything except leisure. So all in this place of heaven are they are very busy. People are very busy doing work. They are all workaholic. They enjoy doing work. They find pleasure in being busy doing work. Here men say, God, we haven't a moment to spare. Women whisper, let's hurry on, dear, time is flying. All exclaim, time is precious. So they are all conscious of the valuable time, and they are trying to meet their deadline. They are trying to finish one work after the other. They don't even have time to speak. We are always having our hands full. We are making use of every single minute. They sigh complainingly, and yet those very words make them feel happy and exalted. They feel so happy and energized with the feeling that they have a lot of work in their hands. They are not feeling burdensome with the loads of work that are given to them. They enjoy their work and complete it one after the other. But this newcomer who had passed all his life in the planet Earth without any employment did not fit in with the scheme of things in workers' paradise. How will he fit in the workers' paradise? In his whole lifetime, he didn't do a single useful work. And after going to workers' paradise, he found people engaged in every sort of work. They're all hardworking people. Then how will he able to adjust there? He is not finding comfortable there at all. It is like another world for him. So what he did, he lounged in the street absent-mindedly and jostled with hurrying men. So he tried to continue the same lifestyle even if he is in workers' paradise. He didn't try any useful work there. He continued lounging there. He continued lazing around there, passing time, doing unnecessary things. And he started disturbing other people also. He started going. He wanted to talk to other people. So nobody is free there. Nobody has time to talk. Even then he goes and try to disturb other people. He lay down in green meadows and was taken to task by busy farmers. So nowhere he can find people lazing around. So if he go and lie down on the farm, then farmers will come and ask him to get out from there. He was always in the way of others. He is always disturbing others. They don't have time for him. A hustling, active girl went every day to a silent torrent. Silent, for in the workers' paradise, even the torrent did not waste its energy by singing. She went to fill her pitcher with water. So in the workers' paradise, you have a beautiful torrent over there. You have a beautiful water body that is a stream over there. Usually, if we go near a waterfall or a stream, you can feel the music of water falling. But here in the workers' paradise, even the torrent is so busy that we cannot even hear that music. So near the torrent, who is there? There is a very active, energetic, busy girl filling water in her pot. Okay, and she is standing near that silent torrent. The girl's movement on the road was like a rapid movement of a skilled hand on the strings of a guitar. So she doesn't want to waste even a second. So how do we how is she taking water from the torrent? She is taking it as fast as possible, like a fast music on the strings of a guitar. Her hair was carelessly done. A few inquisitive wisps flew on to her white forehead to peep at the dark wonders of her eye. It is beautifully described in a literary way. She is very busy. She doesn't even have time to get her hair done. So it is all carelessly done. The unemployed man was standing by the fountain motionless. So who is going there and disturbing this girl? Our own wrong man who is mistakenly been to workers' paradise. So he found this girl. So he thinks, let me go and disturb her. She is very busy doing her work. Now let me talk to her about my artworks and all. As princess sees a lonely beggar through her window and is filled with pity, so the busy girl of heaven saw the unemployed man and was filled with pity. No individual is unemployed in the workers' paradise. All are very, very busy doing their work. So only this lazy wrong man is roaming around, lazing around without any work. So just like a princess sympathizing with a beggar, this young girl also sympathizes with this. She feels pity for this wrong man, unemployed wrong man. Aha, she said, you haven't any work in hand, have you? The man sighed, oh, work? I haven't any moment to spare for work. What work you are all doing? I don't want to do any work. I don't have any time to spare for work. I am already very busy doing my artwork, creating sculptures and all that. They are all valuable for me. I don't want your useless work. I don't want to do hard work at all. The girl did not understand his words. So she said, I may manage to spare some work for you if you like. The girl cannot understand this man because she has never seen a person like that in workers' paradise. All are busy with their own work. So this man, this useless man, what is he doing? He is just loitering around and disturbing her. So what is she saying? She says, if you want some work, I can manage to give you. I have loads and loads of work to be completed. So if you want, I can just give you a few work. A man replied, girl of the silent torrent, all this time I have been waiting here only to take some work from your hands. She asked, what sort of work would you like? He said, girl of the silent torrent, couldn't you give me one of the pictures? One which you could spare. You have lot of water pots with you. So can you give me one pot so that I can paint on it? Oh, she said, a picture? Perhaps you should like to draw water from the torrent. Oh, you need water pot to get water from the torrent. Yeah, I'll give you. But what he replied, no, I'll draw pictures on the picture. No, I don't want to take water, I don't want to do any useful task, but I have to spend time drawing pictures on the pot that you have. The girl became annoyed. She became very irritated and said, I have no time to waste on such as you. I'm going. And away she went. She told, No, I don't have time to waste for useless people like you. So I'm just going. Don't come and disturb me. But how could a busy person get the better of one who had nothing to do? Every day they met, and every day he said to her, Girl of the silent torrent, give me one of your pictures. I will draw a picture on it. So every day this man will go and disturb this girl of silent torrent. At last she had to give away. Oh my God, he is disturbing every day. So let me give a pot to him so that he'll just go. The man began to paint on it. He drew line after line. He put color after color. So there is no sense in his painting. It is only for the pleasure of painting that he is doing, and nobody can make out any meaning out of that painting. What is he doing? He is just scribbling like kids painting. He is just putting line after line and color after color, and he is enjoying, but nobody else can enjoy seeing that pathetic painting. When he had finished, the girl held up the picture and stared at its side with eyes filled with wonder. Then, brows drawn into the arch, she asked, What do they mean, all these lines and all these colors, and what is their purpose? So, whatever they do in workers' paradise should be purposeful, should have some meaning. But this painting doesn't have any meaning at all. What does it mean, and is that painting has any purpose? The man laughed, Nothing. A picture never has any meaning, and it never serves any purpose. So that is the main slogan of art for art's sake. So in the beginning we have discussed the motto of art for art's sake. It is a movement that was started in the 19th century by French philosopher Victor Cousin. There are many other writers, many other people who have followed the same art for art's sake movement. One to say mention will be Edgar Allan Poe, the American writer and poet. Another is Walter Pater. He is an English essayist. And then you have another Irish writer, Oscar Wilde. Oscar Wilde said that all art is useless. Art need not express anything but itself. So this painter, this artist also follows the same kind of movement. But this movement later on had to meet severe criticism, okay? Because art cannot stay in a vacuum. Art has to express whatever is there in the life. And art is also used as a protest by some people to voice their opinion and all. Okay, so let us go to the next slide. The girl went away with the picture. She doesn't want to talk to him. She just goes away from him. At home, away from the prying eyes, she held it in the light, turned it round and round, and scanned the painting from all angles. So this man is disturbing her every day. So it makes a little change in that girl also. So she starts observing his paintings. So even at home, when everybody sleeps, this girl takes the pot and she looks at the painting. She keeps it near the light and she observes what is there in silence and wonder. For the first time in her life, she had seen something that had no meaning and no purpose at all. So she realizes that there are these kinds of enjoyment, pleasurable things also in life. She has never seen those kinds of people and those kinds of art forms in her life before. When she set out for the torrent next day, her hurrying feet was a little less hurrying than before. She was not that energetic and active that day because she didn't sleep properly yesterday. She was just passing her time observing the pot that the wrong man has given. So She is not that fast and that quick today. In her mind, thoughts had arisen. Thoughts had no meaning and no purpose at all. So she is also getting attracted to that young man, that wrong man. She saw the unemployed man standing by the torrent and she asked confusedly, "But what? What do you want? Today, what do you want? I have already given the picture, you have painted on it, and why are you coming here again and disturbing me?" He said, "Only some more work from your hands. I need some more work from you. Please give me some more work." "And what sort of work would you like?" "Let me weave a colored ribbon for your hair if you will." "And what for?" "Nothing." "What for are you making my ribbon colorful? Let it be as it is. Why do you want to make it colorful?" Ribbons were made gleaming with colors. The busy girl of workers' paradise had now to spend a long time every day in trying the colored ribbon around her hair. The minutes slid by unutilized. Much work was left unfinished. So this man, he painted on the ribbon and he made it gleaming, shining, colorful. And then now this young girl is spending most of her time noticing herself in the mirror, how the hair looks and all that. Earlier her hairstyle used to be shabby and she never had time to do her hair, but now the situation has changed. This wrong man has had a great influence on her, influence on her. In workers' paradise, work had of late begun to suffer. So more and more people are getting attracted to this kind of lifestyle of a wrong man. So work has started suffering. Many persons who had been active before were now idle, wasting their precious moments in unnecessary things such as painting and sculpture. So many are getting influenced by this man, by this artist. Many are trying to spend time making sculptures and doing paintings and all. So they are finding pleasure in these kinds of little things. Okay, so life is not only doing useful things. We have to have a hobby and we have to spend our time in things that we find pleasure on. The elders became anxious. There are a lot of elder people also there. The seniors are becoming anxious. Oh, the situation is getting serious. We have to do something. A meeting was called. They called for a meeting. All agreed that such a thing had so far been unknown in the history of workers' paradise. There had never been a person like this, idle person like this. And now this wrong man has come to paradise and he has started influencing many people here. So people are turning lazy. They are spending their time doing nothing. They are making sculptures. They are painting and wasting time doing useless things. The aerial messenger hurried in, bowed before the elders and made a confession. So he had to confess. The aerial messenger had to mention that it is his mistake. He made a mistake by bringing the wrong man here into the workers' paradise. "I brought a wrong man in this paradise," he said. "It is all because of him. It is all due to him. The whole chaos is due to the wrong man." The man was summoned. So somebody called the wrong man. He came in. The elders saw his fantastic dress, his quaint brushes, his pile of paintings, and they raised at once that he was not the right sort for the workers' paradise. So this man, this artist came in a strange way. So these elders have never seen a person like this. He came in a fantastic dress. He had a different kind of dressing style and he had so many strange painting brushes with him. He had a pile of paintings with him. So all this looked strange in the workers' paradise. Stiffly, the president said, "There is no place for a person like you. Therefore, you will have to leave from here at once. So, get out from here at this moment. We don't have time to spare for you. We don't have time to spend for you. So the man is relieved. Now at least he can go back to the earth and then enjoy his life painting and making sculptures. The man sighed in great relief and gathered up his brush and paint. He is very happy to leave the workers' paradise. He has here he has only one girl to disturb, but in earth he has lot of people to enjoy with. So he is very happy to go back to earth. He doesn't find any meaning doing useful things. For him, useful things are his paintings and his artworks. So it differs. Your point of view differs from your friend's point of view. So your friend may be an artist, and for him, artworks are more valuable than the other mundane works. Okay. He was, but as he was about to leave, the girl of the silent current came up tripping and said, "Wait a moment, for I too will go with you." When he is about to leave, somebody else is coming, rushing, tripping, breathing fast, and then said, "Wait a moment, I too will come with you." So who is also going with him? Who is also going with him? The silent girl of Torrent is also hurrying to go with him, because she understands that there is another world, an open world, where you can work as well as enjoy your life doing these kinds of paintings and making sculptures. So she enjoys all those things. She enjoys the beautiful paintings and she enjoys the sculptures. So she wants to see more of those kinds of things. The elders gasped in surprise, but they have never seen such an act before. Never before had such a thing happened in workers' paradise. A thing that had no meaning and no purpose at all. So this is the first time this kind of incident is happening in the workers' paradise, and they can't just digest it, because nobody has just gone out of workers' paradise for the sake of art. So that's all in the story. Hope you enjoyed reading the story. I have given you a reading comprehension. So read the story on your own, read from the textbook, and try to answer these simple questions. I have given you only very simple questions. Four questions are there. Try to read the question on your own and select the best answer from the options given. Let us discuss the vocabulary. I have selected a few words. There is a glossary at the end of the lesson in your textbook. You can read those words also. You can understand the meanings. But here I have selected a few words that you can use in day-to-day conversation, that is valid in our day-to-day conversation and writing also. So the first word is utility. The meaning of utility is a state of being useful, profitable, or beneficial. You might have heard about the movement called utilitarianism. Okay, that is related to the state of being useful. I've given a sample sentence also here so that it is easy for you to understand the meaning of the word. What is the sentence given here? The increase in utility is the same as generating wealth. Only if we do useful things, we'll get money. Indulge. Indulge means involve or allow oneself to enjoy the pleasure of. Example is, I plan to indulge in a favorite pastime, that is reading. I like spending my time reading. Okay. Next is quaint. Quaint means strange, attractively unusual. So the sentence here is, he lived more than 700 years ago in a quaint little town of Italy. You might have heard grandma's stories and all describing about things that happened hundreds and hundreds of years ago. So 700 years ago, this person lived in a strange little town of Italy. Wow means promise. वो ही टुक अ वो टू गिव अप एल्कोहल एंड स्मोकिंग. ही गेव अ प्रॉमिस दैट ही विल क्विट ड्रिंकिंग एल्कोहल एंड स्मोकिंग. नेक्स्ट इज प्लाई. प्लाई इज ट्रैवल. ओके टू गो और ट्रैवल रेगुलरली ओवर. द किड्स वॉच जेट्स प्लाइंग द स्काईज. यू कैन से बस प्लाइंग, बोट्स प्लाइंग. ओके ट्रैवलिंग. नेक्स्ट इज स्पेयर. स्पेयर इज गिविंग टाइम टू समथिंग इन एडिशनल टू वॉट यू आर डूइंग. ओके राइट नाउ दैट इज एडिशनल टू वॉट इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर ऑर्डिनरी यूज. एग्जाम्पल शी आस्क्ड इफ आई कुड स्पेयर सम टाइम फॉर हर. शी वॉन्ट्स टू टॉक टू यू सो शी इज आस्किंग यू कैन यू स्पेयर सम टाइम फॉर मी. कैन यू स्पेंड सम टाइम फॉर मी. दैट इज द मीनिंग. नेक्स्ट इज एग्जाल्ट. एग्जाल्ट इज ग्रेट प्लेजर और हैप्पीनेस. एक्सट्रीम काइंड ऑफ हैप्पीनेस. सो ही वॉज एग्जाल्टिंग इन अ विन एट द कॉम्पिटिशन अर्लियर दैट डे. ही वन इन अ कॉम्पिटिशन इन द मॉर्निंग. सो ही इज वेरी 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 हैप्पी. दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एग्जाल्ट. नेक्स्ट इज लाउंज. लाउंज मीन्स लेजिंग अराउंड. यू कैन जस्ट सिट एंड रिलैक्स. दैट इज लाउंजिंग. He was lounging on the beach. So this person went to the beach and he is sitting there and relaxing. That is lounging. Next is jostle. Jostle is you push the other person forcefully. Typically in a crowd, if you go to the temple and during the time of darshan, many people come and push you. Okay. This happens even in other religious places. Okay. Even in the crowd, was jostling each other, trying to get a better view of their favorite actress. The jostling means pushing one people in a crowd, especially in a crowd. Hustling. Hustling means to proceed or work rapidly or energetically. In this story, you found a silent girl, a silent torrent girl, who's hustling and active. She works very energetically and very active manner. The new joiners came hustling up to the office. Next one is inquisitive. Inquisitive means curious, having or showing an interest in learning things. The kids were inquisitive about the science experiment and their science teacher had tough time keeping her project a surprise. They were very curious. They wanted to do it as soon as possible. So they were not leaving their teacher like that, and she found it a tough job hiding the project from the kids. Annoying. Annoy means causing irritation. This person, the wrong man, annoyed that girl, disturbed the girl. Okay. Example is, I didn't mean to annoy her with all of my questions. Next is pry. That is inquire too closely to one's personal matters. It is not good to pry. Okay. It is not good to ask about personal matters. Sorry, I didn't mean to pry. That is the example given. Next is gasp. Gasp is catch one's breath due to surprise. You say, oh, that is gasp. A woman gasped in horror at the sight of him. Okay, so some ghost has come and the woman is struck there, gasped there in horror. Picture is a large jug. There is difference in pronunciation between picture and picture. This is picture. It is a large jug. I've given a pic there. You can see that. A picture of orange juice was on the table. So that's for today. Thank you for listening. Thank you, students.